This video is a quick overview and demonstration of Glider Score 6.52 created by Gary Carter. Specifically, we're going to demonstrate the e-scoring, but it's a demo competition that we create. We're going to do some pilot entries from a pilot list. As normal, you pick a couple of pilots. I added 3 pilots for this competition just to demonstrate. So the pilots are added. Now what we do is you can set up all the normal parameters for a competition. This is specifically for F5J now, the demonstration. It's a duration competition, so 10 minutes. You can have landing scores as normal. You will have height entry with the height penalties. And then we will have just 3 pilots per group, and there will be 6 rounds. On the report side, when you look at reports, you can do the normal scorecards. Just make sure that you switch on the QR codes, because the QR codes are important to get to the e-site. Also click the URLs link so that the URL is available to type in case there's no QR reader on the phone. When the pilot now gets a scorecard, there will be a QR code at the top, which we'll demonstrate a bit later. A better way to actually print out the scorecards would be the cards that contains all the rounds on the scorecard, because that also contains the URL on the card that you can type in. It's got a QR code and the URL then. Now to go to e-scoring, we need to open this competition for scoring. We need to upload then also this competition to the cloud. I mean, we're soaring, so we're creating a cloud system here. Okay. With the competition now being uploaded to the Glider Score server, it's created and now it's available for the pilots to start entering their scores. This is now basically what the competition director had to do. The pilots need to make sure that they've got a QR scanner on their phone. So install something like QR Droid, it works fine. It's just a standard QR code reader. Go to the Play Store, search for it, install QR on your phone. Now, when your plane has landed, you just look at your height meter, that's part of your competition. You take the score, the timer takes the score, he writes in the height. This is the old way of doing it. He writes in your landing points and he writes in the time of the flight. Now, this is working. There is also a backup, but you can see there on the scorecard there is a QR code. So we can now also do it electronically and add the score electronically. So if we now do this again and we say, how do we do this with new Glider Score and cloud scoring in real time, then we can see that we've got now our Altus there. We take the scorecard out, we take a phone, we run QR Droid, hold it over the QR code, it scans that pilot scorecard in, it goes to that pilot score, you go to round one, group one, you press enter, it takes you to the site where you enter your score in terms of time. So you select your time, the timer puts in your time. Any phone can work for any pilot, okay, as long as you scan the QR code for the pilot who's just flown. Put in your time, you put in your landing, and then you put in your height on the phone. With all of that entered, you can submit the score. The score then goes to the cloud server of Glider Score, and that goes to the competition director. The pilot cannot modify this again. The competition director can do that. You can see the top line is now view only. And that's it. After the pilots have submitted their scores, this competition directory can go to eScore system. They can download the current scores to the PC. That basically takes everything the pilots have entered, downloads it to the competition PC, download it for all the rounds. Then all the information submitted by pilots are now available on the PC of the director. It shows that 2 pilots have not entered the score for round 4. That means round 1, 2 and 3 has been completely entered. The competition director can now go onto the scoring system and he can then go and modify or upload the pilots who could not electronically upload their own scores. So on here you can see for round 1, these pilots have entered their scores. If we go to round 4, you will see that those 2 pilots have not entered any score. The competition director can now enter it manually, or you can ask the pilots to quickly do that and then download the data again. The pilots can now view on their phones round 1, 2, 3. Because round 4 is not completed yet, but he uploaded, the competition director uploaded the information. You can see round 1, round 2. If you scroll down, you can see on round 2 what's the ranking dynamically for that round for the different pilots. If you go to round 3, there's also the ranking for the pilot. So the pilots have immediate view of the rankings. They can see the score is added. The system works excellent, it's quite easy to use, and it takes a lot of the workload off the competition director at the end.